Morning, Trainiacs. It's my birthday. It is 36 years young. Feels good. It's not going to feel good in a minute because we are going to do a brutal birthday bike session. That's right. This is going to be one of Team Trainiac's just half hour near puke sessions. That's kind of the premise of the weekday bikes. Really intense, really short. Kind of scared. So, of course, for that, I need the Scotty Team Trainiac kit. I need the Flamingo Sporks socks. And after, we are gonna talk about how I get this gorgeous setup for Zwift on that TV out there. There's three options. They have some pros, they have some cons. And related to that, if you happen to own like a audio visual sort of place and are thinking about birthday presents, I do have in mind like a 10-foot projector setup for Zwift. Just thoughts, just throwing it out there. All right, let's go. Oh my God. So that was a 30-minute ride with a calorie burn of 323, intensity factor of 0.87. And how that went was 7 minutes scientifically proven efficient warm-up, and then 4 times, 20 seconds really hard, 40 seconds easy, 1 minute recovery after all of those four, and then repeat that 5 minute chunk 4 times, and then a 5 minute cool down. I joke about throwing up on those. Actually did a little bit. Why we incorporate those into Team Trainiac is because there are a couple different types of fitness. There's central fitness, your heart and lungs, basically your cardiovascular system, and for that, you need to do really low intensity, but really high volume. But for really intense workouts, you maybe only need about 5 to 8 minutes of total intensity to get the effect that you want, which builds up your peripheral fitness, your arms and legs. And I'm sure I've done an excellent job of selling you on that as a training premise. So if you want to join Team Trainiac, go to triathlonterran.com/team. Waitlist so that you can be on the waitlist for when it launches. Now, let me just put myself back together. I'll tell you about Zwift. Okay, back, piece together, wearing a cardigan because that's what older people do. Just gotta play the part. So, I think that there are 3 main ways that you can get Zwift onto a TV. Let's talk first about the current Apple TV. Now we're talking about one of the 4K Apple TVs that has an app store built in. Zwift is one of only 2 indoor cycling apps that has an app in the app store. And the really nice thing about this is that there is no latency between getting the Zwift feed from, say, a phone or an iPad to the TV. So the feed is really good. It streams in full 1080p HD quality, and it is buttery smooth, 30 frames per second. One thing that the 4K Apple TVs are known for having like a downside to them, it's that they can only allow 3 Bluetooth connections, and 1 is already taken up by the phone. But how Zwift has created their app is that it functions as 1 Bluetooth connection, and all of the connections of all of your peripherals, your trainer, your heart rate, your cadence, everything is coming from that. They smart. So the next least janky option is actually gonna save you a fair amount of money. That is getting Zwift on either an iPad or an iPhone, which most people already have. It's basically free. And to get a really strong signal, what you can do is get a Lightning to HDMI adapter, take that cable and plug it directly into the TV. Now, what you'll avoid is a little bit of that skipping that ends up happening when you try to stream something from your iPhone or your iPad to the TV, which often happens via Bluetooth. Bluetooth is not foolproof. A couple of downsides to this. One is that you got a cable running across whatever, your living room, your pain cave. And then the second real downside to that is that Zwift is a battery killer. Streaming somewhere around 2 hours of Zwift typically ends up murdering an entire phone battery or an iPad battery. And once you plug into that cable, you can't then go and charge the iPhone or the iPad. So you're playing a bit of a game where you're like, ooh, am I gonna be able to get the workout in time? Or if you have a modern iPhone, like an iPhone 8 or newer, you can put it on a wireless charger, which you can get for 40 or 50 bucks while it's plugged in to that HDMI cable. So that's a really good option. For this, I always recommend going with an iPhone over an iPad, because with an iPhone, you get that nice 16:9 frame size. With an iPad, you end up getting black bars on the side of your TV, and it's less immersive where an iPhone renders correctly. The most janky option is the one that I use. It is to take said iPhone, stream Zwift on that, and then AirPlay it to my old Apple II TV. Now, 95% of the time, this works really well, but just now, while we were trying to get footage of Zwift for this video, it ended up skipping a lot, and that'll often happen because Bluetooth and Wi-Fi connections aren't flawless. Also, if you're doing that from your phone to get that nice 16:9 frame size that matches the TV, most people don't have a spare phone, so your phone is in use while you're on Zwift, and you can't go and take care of anything else on your phone during any rest periods. However, there is something to be said for just focusing on doing the work and having some time away from your phone. So what I do is I bought an old iPhone SE. They're available for about $150, an old Apple TV, somewhere around $50, in which case you're getting basically the same thing as if you were to get an Apple TV 4K, one of the newer ones, because they're both coming in at about $200. But with the other option of having a nice new Apple TV, you get a new Apple TV and you get that crystal clear signal with no jankiness that you've got from this. So there you go, Trainiacs. Those are your three options for getting Zwift streamed on a TV. Very enjoyable, very immersive, feels like you're in it, makes all of the trainer rides go by so much quicker. If you are or aren't subscribed, doesn't really matter, and you aren't following me yet on Zwift, go to T is the first name and the last name is Triathlon space Taren. This winter, we're going to be doing a lot of Zwift group rides for Team Trainiac. So go follow me there. All right, later. I would have made a good Mr. Rogers.